you know, you got to build the kind of city where young men and women want to live and they want to raise their families, and where businesses want to come and recruit those sorts of people. So that's really what we've been doing. Coastal Trail is amazing. There's really nothing like it in the world. I really want people who visit Indianapolis or live in Indianapolis to get out along the Coastal Trail and see how they connect up other parts of the city. I think that's it's very special. It's very distinctive in its design. You can see it all over downtown. Once you get on it, it's hard to get off of it. It feels different when you're riding a bike. I mean, it's just a different feel to it because of how it's been built and what's underneath it. So. But it's the part about connecting up everything that's really made it dramatic and is getting the international attention. We went to the National Bike Summit. We were treated very, very well because of what we've done, and really just in a 4 or 5 year period too, because we had 1 mile bike lanes. I always joke about that. You know, where did 1 mile of bike lanes go to? What did it connect to? I don't know. But now we have 75 miles of on-street bike lanes plus the trails that are out there, and we are on track to get to 200 miles of trails and bike lanes in the city by 2015, and we've done it pretty quickly. You can ride down from anywhere in the city, park your bike inside, take a shower, go in your locker, get your clothes, and go to work. There's one thing I've micromanaged since I've been the mayor, and that is the size of those lockers in there, because I wanted to make sure that they had the ability to put 5 suits in there and their toiletries and underwear and everything else, so they could put it in there over the weekend, then they could ride to work or run to work or whatever they wanted to do, and it's right along the Coastal Trail, so it's a great place for that too. It started with the mayor's bike ride in June, and that was the first Saturday in June every year. Now we have a Spring Fever kickoff. We just did that. So to kind of get people in the mood for riding a bike throughout the summer, get them outside a little bit more. We have something called the Polar Bear Pedal, which is only 2 years old, and we ride the first Saturday in January, which is traditionally very cold here in Indianapolis. And so that's been a lot of fun. It just took off. I mean, that is the most attended bike ride that we do. I mean, we had just under 1,000 riders last year in the cold weather. We were the first city in the nation to commit to getting all of our vehicles off of oil, if you will. We call it post-oil technology, and that's really what we're trying to move to. Now this, some people look at it from one angle, an environmental angle. I don't look at it like that. In fact, I really don't talk about it in that regard, to be frank, because I was a 23-year Marine, served in the Gulf War. You're not going to tell me that war was not about oil. It certainly was. I'm not bashing oil companies. I'm not doing that sort of thing because I don't think that's relevant. What I'm really trying to tell people is that we have been protecting a system for a long time now that allows us to send money to people who want to do us harm, and we shouldn't be doing that anymore. We're committing to buying only plug-ins or EVs from here on out for our cars, the non-police cars. We're going to convert our fire trucks to natural gas, and for police cars, we're certainly going to try to look at getting at least a hybrid 40 to 50 miles a gallon, if not a plug-in. In a city, in a major city particularly, you have to create that kind of city that will attract the businesses. If you don't do that, it doesn't matter if you're Republican or Democrat, you have to create that kind of city because everybody's competing for these young professionals, everybody's competing for the businesses, and if you don't have that kind of city, then they're going to look somewhere else. We have a lot going on in the city of biking, and it's really kind of taken off. They needed the infrastructure, they needed the encouragement, and you can just look around today, it's obvious what's happening.